We'll now be going over the main points of those in favour and those against Britain joining the common market. Starting with the arguments of those in favour of joining the common market. After a numerous amount of wars, joining a union together will stop the constant fighting and death. British industry will thrive within the common market, as many Europeans are desperate to buy British goods, and the UK production will increase when we join the common market, as there will be more demand. Britain is just a small island all on our own, and without the Europeans, we'll sink into obscurity. The common market will help finance British industry and help us trade further abroad. British business will move to high growth economies within the common market if we fail to join. Britain paying more into the common market than it gets out will only be in the short term.
But people have frightened us, the anti-marketeers have frightened us with ideas about the size of this entrance fee. If you add it all up in a realistic fashion, what you're going to have to sacrifice is the probable growth of our exports in 1 year. The amount of increase in our exports in one good year will have to go into this entrance fee. From then on, we're on our own, and I take it that we're going to grow faster, and if we grow even moderately faster, we shall be many, many hundreds of millions of pounds richer at the end of 5 to 10 years.
In the long term, other economies will be paying an equal amount to Britain. The nations within the common market are growing quicker than the UK. Therefore, if the UK joins, our economy will also grow quicker. Labour unions will have much more power and influence when they merge with European unions, and this will give British workers more rights and pay. When we join, the price of goods will go down, as the UK will be able to import cheaper common market goods. The common market is not only a market, but also a club, and the members of the club will bail each other out when things go wrong, protecting failing British business. Joining the common market will over time offer greater educational options to UK students and workers. The faceless bureaucrats in Brussels will have little to no say over British people's everyday lives. Very little will change on a local level, and British people will still feel British.
I feel a Dutchman now, and just the same as 20 years before when common market started. I can't see any difference now in those 20 years between me, my being a Dutchman.
National independence is out of date. All nations are coming together in big blocs, and failure to join a big bloc will result in the UK losing say of what happens in the world.
There is no doubt, Europe is not playing a real part in economic, but much more in political affairs in the world. It has a choice to remain divided and to play no real part, or to unite and to play a real part. That means to be a partner to the free world and not a satellite of one or the other big powers. So I believe it's a fate of most of the European countries which still have officially a sovereignty, but very often and in decisive fashion can't make use of it.
The UK will remain fully sovereign. Every law will be made in the House of Commons, and there's no chance of a European army. The common market is not a federal bloc. When foreign nations want to invest in Europe, they will ask the common market where the best place to invest is. If the UK is not part of the common market, the UK will fail to gain this investment. The UK can't keep going as we are. If we join the common market now, we can turn the tide, improve peace in the world, and grow the UK economy. Be sure to check out my other channel, History Sticks, for the complete, longer, and comprehensive video.